How did this happen? How did you first meet him?
You know, it was one of those nights in New York City where a girlfriend invited me to meet her out. I had been working at the time, and I got off work late, so they had already been out. And I went to Cipriani's, which is a pretty well-known place in Manhattan. And it was a big table of people and from all different, you know, walks of life, business people. And I sat in the empty seat, and Harvey Weinstein came up behind me and said, "I think you're in my seat." And I recognized him immediately, and I apologized. And he said, no, stay there. And he pulled up a chair next to me, and we just, you know, began chatting. And he was very kind, really engaging. We talked about news. We talked about politics. This was 10 years ago, and at the time, I was a local news anchor on, you know, News 12 Long Island, my hometown station, and I was just desperate to be taken seriously. And so a conversation like that with Harvey Weinstein was wildly flattering.
Sure.
And like I said, he was just really kind and charming and lovely. And when, you know, the night went on and we moved to a different venue, and he asked me, "Hey, I actually own this place. Would you like to see the restaurant and the kitchen downstairs?" I said, "Sure, why not?" I had no reason to believe, you know, anything mysterious was going on.
Right, you're in a public place.
We're in a public place. You know, there's plenty of people upstairs all chatting and drinking and enjoying themselves. So when we got downstairs, though, I thought it was going to be like this bustling kitchen with people screaming and, you know, plates shattering, and there was no one there. It was desolate. There was a guy sweeping up. And so when he dismissed that guy sweeping...
He told the guy sweeping up to leave.
To leave. And we were completely alone. And that's when I realized this was a bad idea and I need to get back upstairs. But at that point, I said to him, like, "You know what? I've seen it. I want to go." And he said, no, just come back here with me. Walk back this way with me. I'll show you the rest. And he walked me into like a vestibule. So it was a dead end, basically. And he stood in front of the doorway, and he tried to kiss me. And I said, I pulled away, and I told him I apologized. I wasn't interested, and I'm in a relationship, and I'm sorry, and kind of intimated, like, let's go back upstairs. And that's when he told me, you know, "Can you just stand there and be quiet?"
He actually said, "Just stand there and be quiet."
Yeah. So that was a completely different person than the guy upstairs who was chatting and was friendly and was engaging and made me feel great, to "Can you just stand there and be quiet?" And that's when I realized, I didn't know what was going to happen, but I knew something was about to happen.
And what happened?
He exposed himself, and he just began masturbating in front of me, and I just stood there kind of frozen.